Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue Eden Street here in the Binding of Isaac Invicta Afterbirth Plus series. Hope you all had a fantastic Easter holiday yesterday. Mine turned out to end up pretty good because I got to eat some of the Easter dinner, despite not being able to spend it with family, of course. But we made do. So, unfortunately, yes, we are starting off of a little bit of a bad note this week because the like streak has indeed been broken. Unfortunately, the compost KO video, which came out now 48 hours ago, did not pass 3,000 likes, so unfortunately we got to go back to zero. I tried to give it as much time as possible. It currently, at the time of this recording, sitting at 2852, even if that one did pass, it looks like yesterday's video might not do it either. So I think that Easter may have had something to do with it, but we can talk about it after we start this run. Here's your meme of the day, brought to you by someone who has an expletive in their name, so I will not be saying their name. But it's a pretty good one. It's Invicta trying to explain how Polyphemus works. That you're piercing, but this does not mean you are piercing. I can't do a Russian accent. I wish I could, so. Here we go. Get it rocking and rolling, then we'll talk about the like streak. Oh, man. C-Day is going to be Sierra, Juliet, Papa, Golf, 1 Charlie, Kilo, 8. We've got Shoop to Whoop, Kinda Bad Damage, Trendy Shield, Tears Rate, and a decent Tears Rate, and not a bad shot speed. We also have the DN Fizzle, which I'm not going to use, although could use it on Shoop, but do we want to use it on Shoop? Let's think about that for the moment. The D-Infinity is going to give us, obviously it started off with the D6, which means that we will be able to reroll any item pedestal that we see. However, now is not the time for us really to worry about that. Because we do have 1 HP, we need to be very careful. This is not Curse the XL, so don't have to worry about that. So yeah, it's a bummer about the like streak. A lot of people were looking forward to blacklisted items week, but not enough, unfortunately. I tried to give it as much time as possible. I suspected that Easter may have done something, may have had a hand to play in that. Obviously, the weekends, something that I've acknowledged before, is that the weekends always do tend to be a little bit lower. Like, it's a more of a slower burn on the weekend. But the fact of the matter is that, like, if it needed more, like, another, like, 12 hours or so, like, you know, maybe it's permissible and I could kind of have some leeway, but it's been 48 hours now, so I don't think that... You know, we got to play fair. This is how I interpret it. Anytime that we drop a like streak, and it's not that common that we do. I could gamble this here, but I'm not going to. Let's keep our safety under control first before I start worrying about gambling. Because I do want the Steam sale, but like I said, looking for safety right now. The way I look at it, anytime that we miss the like streak, it means that I could have done something better. Whether it's the commentary could have been better, or whether the run could have been better, I always feel like I have failed at some point. Whenever we get the situation where, you know, it's like, well, the video didn't catch on as much as it should have, or much as it could have. You know, what could I have done differently? And that video in particular is very intriguing because the views on the compost KO video were very good. I mean, they're over 40,000 right now, and that's amazing. You know, that's far above average what we usually do, numbers wise here for an everyday Isaac episode. But it was the likes that were really, really sort of lagging behind on that one, and you know, it I hate the saying, but it is what it is. You know, I look at it as just that I just need to work harder. I just need to do a better job and provide better commentary, provide better gameplay, whatever the case may be. And you know, we'll start a new one. And if it's looking like we can't hit 3,000, may not be a possibility anymore. Then you know, if this one fails, then we'll have to reevaluate it, and maybe drop it down again. We'll see. We shall see. But we did pass 145,000 subscribers, though, which again is why it's so mystifying. Although, I will say that I think that Animal Crossing has done a lot for the channel, in bringing new people here that don't necessarily even watch Isaac. You know, so it really is interesting to see what affects what. You know, it's almost like its own little. I'm going to say view ecosystem in a way. Like, it's its own economy, I think. It might be better. Well, maybe not economy. Maybe more like it's its own commodity. Every video has cultivated its own little following, and, you know, and there's all, and the perks and the quirks about it and all that stuff. So, you know, one affecting the other in a somewhat symbiotic relationship is pretty fascinating. And that's always the sweet science behind the matter on YouTube, is figuring out what works, what doesn't. You know, what game, you know, may tend to cannibalize, you know, viewers versus their attention and engagement, blah, blah, blah. I mean, it's a whole bunch of boring new media stuff, but all that stuff gets looked at by me. So, and yeah, I will attempt to do better. I know I can do better, so let's do better. This is I should at least feel partially thankful that we have enough tiers to keep up with Champion Duke. Yellow Champion Duke is pretty awful, just because, as you saw here from this fight, how often it spawns the ads. It's far, far more common for it to spawn ads than other versions of Duke. Now, I'm not too sold here on the Trinity Shield. The Trinity Shield did save us one time from taking damage. But I wouldn't mind re-rolling it via the D Infinity, which is what I'm going to do. Or at least I'm gonna re-roll Shoot first, and then we'll see what the D Infinity turns into. Turn it to the D4. I will take Explosivo. Explosivo is going to help us out with damage a little bit, but obviously there is a kind of a risk-reward factor there. I mean, Explosivo can work out very well, especially if you have enough movement speed to get away from the tiers. But ultimately, we will probably re-roll this on the next D4 charge, and we'll head on down. Buckle up. It's going to be a wacky one. So we're going to go with All Angel Deals Week again. That one was very, very popular. And I think that, you know, I don't mind doing repeat light goals. That's one of the things I've been trying to stay away from, was not necessarily repeating light goals and stuff, but just making sure that the light streak goals don't, like, outdo themselves, you know? Because, like, at a certain point, you can only escalate so much to where it's like there's nothing to go past. There's nowhere to go after this, you know? It's like, okay, well, first the hero has to save the neighborhood, and then, oh, you gotta save the entire town. Oh, you gotta save the city. Then the hero's gotta save the world. And then, oh, we gotta save the galaxy. And it's like, well, you know, what next? I'm not insinuating that I'm a hero of any type, but you see my point. The ever escalating amount of what's on the line. And the same thing kind of holds true for the like streak in a way. I don't want to get to the point where I'm like, you know, hey, if we get the next 30-day like streaks, you get like a $100 Amazon gift card. You know what I mean? Like, that's I don't want to feel like I need to go that route to just do something, to keep something up that's been a lot of fun and very, very successful for the channel. Sprinkler, you know I like you, but we're gonna D4 this right now. Let's see what we can get. Oh my goodness. Ipecac, Charm of the Vampire, and Polydactyl. Wow. What a reroll. Yeah, I don't mind sticking with Ipecac here, I suppose. I'm not entirely opposed to rerolling it either, but especially now that we've got the map, I'm less inclined to do so. Now, obviously, it goes without saying. Oh, well, okay. Well, first off, let's see what's inside of this crawl space here. It's probably nothing special. And, boy, was I right. It goes without saying you have to be very careful when it comes to Ipecac, and we also shouldn't probably use the sprinkler. But the problem is with the D-Infinity is that the next roll is the D-8. And you don't want to get stuck with Ipecac and the D-8, because if you get... There is a chance that you could get a basically almost negative range, and if that happens, we're done. We cannot go any further. So for those of you wondering why I'm not sticking with the D-Infinity and using the D-8, it's for that very reason. Had we not rolled Ipecac, I definitely would still keep going with the rerolls, but you can't take the chance with getting almost zero range with the D8. I just don't trust it, and that's it. That's it. I have had runs before where the Ipecac range was so low, thanks to something like number one or something like the D8, the range was so low that it would immediately detonate as soon as Isaac fired, and that's when it's GG after that. You literally cannot do anything without dying. So I'm going to have to avoid doing that by just simply not using the D8. Now, is there a chance that that's not going to happen? Yeah, of course, sure. There's always a chance that nothing's going to happen, but there's always a chance that something is going to happen, though. You know, and with the like streak going belly up, you know, I don't really want to bring this episode down anymore by losing the streak. I mean, obviously, comparatively speaking, between the two, losing the streak would be far more devastating. To a lot of people, and myself as well. I mean, I'm bummed about losing the like streak for sure. We had 140 some odd streak or something like that before it ended, and that's almost half a year. I mean, that's insane. That's absolutely incredible, especially after we raised it three times. These juicy are going to give us more damage and range, which is exactly what we need. And I will take Dark Bum. Dark Bum makes me feel a little bit hopeful that we might actually get to use our sprinkler. Get Dark Bum. And let's go back into the curse room real fast. Dark Bum is a familiar that will just simply walk around and pick up red hearts. Every 1.5 red hearts he picks up, he has a chance of paying out with a soul heart or attack spider or an actual spider. It's kind of whatever mood Dark Bum is in. And we've already had our talk today. We've had our pre-talk warm-up just in case we saw him. So, you know, Dark Bum, get your head in the game, son. Didn't mean to pick that up. That was my bad. My head was not in the game. Blue Hourglass is actually interesting here as well. But I have confidence in my ability to wield Ipecac without being a huge threat to myself. Got a Joker card. I am A-okay with that. This should be another Joker card. Or not. Of clubs. Most of the time, it will be a repeating playing card. Not all the time, but most of the time. It's actually more rare that you find back-to-back playing cards like that and it not repeat. That's a little bit of a shocker there. But we will head on down. Very good damage. We got a good space bar item if we can get some kind of explosion immunity. And I feel like it's been a while since we've seen Ipecac as well, just straight up Ipecac. I'm trying to remember when the last time was. I talked about this on stream a couple days ago. Somebody was asking me, "Hey, Zinvicta, do you remember what you did in episode 472? I was like, no, I do not. Somebody had asked a question. I don't even remember what the question was at this point, but it was something pertaining to that previous day's episode of Isaac. And I was honest with him. I was like, dude, like straight up, I don't remember most of the runs that I record. It's only the really bad ones or the really good ones that stand out to me. You know, and the problem is twofold because I play so much Isaac during the week, and then I also, you know, lead off every stream with at least one Isaac run, that they literally all run together, to the point where it's like my brain is on autopilot and I'm not really noticing half the things that are going on. Like, oh, you like, you know, why didn't you go back and get this, or oh, how come you did that? I'm like, dude, I don't know. I have no idea. You'd have to ask me at the time, because there was either a particular reason why I didn't pick something up and I didn't explain it, or I literally forgot about it. It's one of those. And I keep telling people that, and people still don't believe me. They're like, so no one can be that forgetful. It's like, I'm not forgetful per se. By the way, Ipecac is exactly the reason why I don't pick up Face Reward. It's not that I'm forgetful necessarily. It's just that they seriously all blend together. So I don't know what I've said in one Isaac episode to the next. You know, I don't know what was going on that day that when I last recorded. So it's very difficult for me to remember all of them. I can remember most of the items in Isaac just fine, of course, but if you ask me, like, hey, what'd you do on episode 742 of the streak? Whenever you said you were doing this, but then you didn't do this, I'm like, dude, I have no idea. I wish I could tell you with all levels of certainty. I wish I could just recite what I did and didn't do on a certain episode. Very odd placement for the boss room to not be this far away from the starting spawn. You see here that we got these big arcing shots, thanks to Jesus Juice, and it's. I like when we have a lot of. I like when we have a lot of velocity behind our epic axe shots. anything? Oh, good. Well, actually, that is actually quite good. I take my scoff back because I completely forgot that we had. I failed to remember that we had Dark Bum. Dark Bum, Lil Chad, tag team champs of the world. Because Lil Chad's going to be feeding Dark Bum all these half red hearts, and then we are almost indestructible, I would say. Then we get Mega. Oh my goodness gracious. Oh, this run just got turned up to a whole 11. It got turned up to a finger 11, the Canadian progressive rock band. I almost said the Canadian slash rock band, and I was like, wait a second. Canadian isn't a, to my knowledge anyway, Canadian is not a genre of music. I could be wrong. You know, they may be playing instruments up there with penguins and maple trees and hockey sticks and polar bears or whatever, but, you know, it's not, far be it for me to say what is and isn't Canadian music. Of course, I'm speaking in jest. I know that they don't have penguins up there, at least not in the places that I know of. Ain't got no polar bears up there either. See, it's fun to play the dumb American sometimes.
Don't you mean all the time?
I don't think that you get dumber as you get older. I think you just forget more. It's like if you ask me some like quadratic formula question, I used to be able to do that like almost in my sleep, I would say. You're like, hey, what's the capital of this? Or you know, what was the turning point in the Civil War? You know, like stuff like that, like the American Civil War or stuff like that. Like I used to know that stuff with like the back of my hand. Now, and even like chemistry too, I was pretty decent at chemistry. It was the only part of science that I really didn't mind growing up. But like now it's like, dude, I gotta bust out the calculator just to figure out how many bells I'm gonna get in Animal Crossing, you know? And I don't think it's a product of you getting older necessarily. I think it's just your brain, like when you're growing up and you're younger, it's like your brain has much more storage space, you know? And as dumb as this sounds, this is gonna sound ultra boomer. Yeah, sure, why not? This is gonna sound ultra boomer, but like, I also feel that in this day and age, I think that we all get a little bit dumber because of our smartphones. As ironic and as silly as that may seem, if you think about it, I mean, you always have a computer with you, assuming that you have a smartphone. If you don't have a smartphone, then, you know, good for you. I wish I never got a smartphone, to be honest. But we always have, like, a world of knowledge. It may not always be, you know, accurate knowledge, but still, if you wanted to know what the capital of Zimbabwe was, or if you wanted to know who was the president during the start of the American Civil War, that sort of stuff, you know, you don't have to remember that because you just look it up. Same thing goes for directions. When was the last time that you had to stop and think about where something was located? You know, I'm not going to try to get too philosophical on you. All I'm saying is that with the amount of knowledge that we have and the ease of accessibility, we don't have to remember things anymore. We don't have to remember phone numbers anymore. We don't have to remember directions anymore. We don't have to remember all that stuff from school that we were learning when we really were still kind of like figuring out our intelligence and whatnot. And I think that that plays a part of it as well. It certainly has for me, because like I don't remember the last time I had to memorize a phone number. I don't remember the last time I had to memorize anything. That's the scary part. Is that, you know, you think about it, it's like, wow, I really don't have to memorize anything. It's like, you know, what do I need to remember this for? I can just look it up. You know, and I feel like that's a dangerous way of being, just because it's like, you'll get to the point, like, in a weird way, I sort of feel like my brain has become Mr. Burns in a sense, where, like, he stopped knowing how to take care of himself because he just always had something else to do it for him. It's a very classic Simpsons episode where Homer assaults Mr. Burns because he wasn't feeling appreciative. Like, basically, Homer becomes the new Smithers, and Homer starts doing everything for Mr. Burns. But then, you know, as the episode progresses, Homer becomes worse and worse at taking care of him, and like he was like setting cereal on fire, you know, that whole stuff. It's a great episode. It's classic Mr. Burns, Homer. But Mr. Burns had forgotten how to do everything that he needed to take care of himself with. And it was because he always had people constantly surrounding him doing stuff for him. And I sort of feel like that's what smartphones have been doing to me. Maybe, I mean, that's not going to hold true for everybody. Like, everyone's different, obviously. But it's like, yeah, if you tell me, hey, this is, there's missing no. This is the reason why we don't take blind items in secret rooms right there. Very rare run today. But like, if someone tells me like, hey, this is how you get here, you gotta go here, take a left, take a right, at the mall, I'm like, just give me the address. Like, just give me the address and I'll find it. You know, like, I constantly stop my parents if they tell me to like, hey, you, like, go here to pick up dry cleaners or something. Like, you know, just any random task that you would ask to go to of a place that I normally wouldn't go to. And I'm like, yeah, just give me the address. Like, I'll give you an example. This is a perfect example here. I had to get my car, my driver's seat reupholstered. I think I talked about this when I actually got it done. But the place that I was getting, that the upholstery was getting redone at, is a place that I've never been to. And the person who recommended me going to the store, she gave me very elaborate directions or whatever, and I just simply asked for the address. So I was like, yeah, I don't need to really remember this. Just give me the address. That's all I need. I got the directions right here. And I used my phone to find the store, to find the shop. Well, it turns out that the place that I was going to had a very similar name to another place that was not the correct place to go. And that's the first, I found the wrong location, essentially, because it was a very, very similar name to the business, except they did two completely different things. And I was like, well, maybe I should go back and ask for directions. So I ended up calling the person who recommended this store to me, and was like, hey, what's the directions again? And I could not remember what she told me. I just couldn't remember. My brain was like, oh yeah, it's kind of like passing the responsibility of reminding you or to remember something onto something else or someone else. That's kind of what my brain does, you know. And I think that I don't think I'm alone in that. I might be. I might just be rambling on about nothing right now. But for me personally, I do feel that my smartphone has played a significant role in my ability to recollect things a little bit more accurate. Because I don't have to remember stuff. I don't remember phone numbers anymore. I remember my mom's phone number, my dad's phone number, my home phone number, and that's it. That's all I remember, because it's like, why do we have to? You know. And by the way, I'm not saying this is a good thing either. I actually think it's quite the opposite. I think it's a little bit of a bad thing. We went from the D and we went from the from D4ing ourselves with the D Infinity to now finding the D4. I'm gonna not take this. Alright, well I'm not gonna take that either. What were you? Tower card. No thanks. We could go back and play the arcade to get the blanky. I think that's not a bad idea. Or it's not an arcade. That's actually even better. I will take this. I will happily take the bedroom. So, touching the bed when you have no red hearts and nothing but soul hearts will give you 3 soul hearts automatically. If we even had 1 red heart container, we would have only filled up that 1 red heart container. That's it. We would have not gotten the soul hearts. So what you want to do whenever you find this room is to essentially use it only if you have a lot of red hearts and you need to heal yourself, or if you have soul hearts and nothing but soul hearts. Thank you, Contagion, for saving us for the hit there. And yeah, I could have gone back to get the counterfeit penny to make sure that we got the blanky, but to be honest, I wasn't expecting to see any money. So, if that was an arcade, I would have gone back to get the counterfeit penny, but it doesn't matter anyway now because we've already gotten the we've already gotten it. So the blanket's going to be very nice. It gives us the holy mantle effect as long as we're inside of a boss room. It does not restart. It does not refresh itself if you walk out, walk back in. Once the boss is defeated, its effect is gone. Or if you take damage, it's also gone. And I didn't want to use Mega on this floor either, mainly because of how twisty-turny it was. And without knowing exactly where the boss is, especially with it being Dank Depths 2, unless we're just like on a super roll, I'm not going to use Mega on this floor. Because I know that we're not going to be able to just blast through the entire place, you know. And with Ipecac here, Ipecac's going to make things a lot easier, obviously. But I do like me some Mega. I don't think you're going to be hard-pressed to find a space bar item that's more hard-carry than Mega. Mega pretty much sets the standard in the bar for hard-carry. You see, we have the Holy Mantle effect now. That's from the blanket. A deal with the devil. No surprise there. We'll head on down. But like I say, don't get discouraged by the like streak ending. I'm not. It just, as I've always said, what's the best part about losing a streak? You just get to start a new one. That's all we got to do. And if it turns out that 3,000 likes is not attainable or not realistic anymore, then we'll drop it back down. And you know, I will work harder to come up with like streak goals that are more appealing to people. By the way, for those of you who ever believe the myth that Matriarch can only spawn in the Scarred Womb. Here you go. Somebody was questioning my claim that is false. Just a solid boss. Real solid boss. I sure hope Repentance comes out with more bosses like this. People were asking me if I even saw the, apparently on April 1st, Ed or somebody tweeted out that Repentance will be out at the end of June or something like that. Some date was given in June. I didn't even see that post, but knowing that it was April, that was April 1st, I would not have believed that for a second. I'm actually not going to take Incubus here. Incubus turns into basically the same reason why I don't take Fate's Reward with Ipecac. Ipecac makes it worse. Dodging 1 Ipecac shot, sure, no problem at all. We're gonna take some damage, but for the most part, it's not all that dangerous. But trying to dodge two, especially when one of them is trailing behind you in the fourth or technically third position, that's a good way to get hit. And that's not something that I want to do. So, you know, don't get me wrong. I think everybody knows that Incubus is top tier. Because it really is. But when it comes down to it, there's no way that with Ipecac, there's absolutely no way that I take it under any circumstance. Krampus here. Head of Krampus wouldn't be too bad here, except that we have Mega, so I'm not going to do that. Chariot card is actually pretty decent here. That's what I wanted to see. I was just getting ready to say, I hope we get a Womb Room. We're definitely due for one. This is Dark Bum's wet dream right here, which is a sentence I should probably never say again, but you know, we've made our choices in life. And we'll head on down. Let's go see Stanley, shall we? That's the thing for me, man, is that I never am satisfied with the job that I do. And if I ever fall short of a goal or something like that, I always have to reevaluate. It's like, well, what could I have done better, you know? I personally don't think that you can ever be good enough to be satisfied. It's a concept I've talked about a lot because it's something that I've always dealt with before. Oh, come on. Oh, you gonna do me like that, game? Two of them spawning down there. You know, it's not in my mind, it's not really much of a inferiority complex as it is. It's just like, I think that you should always challenge yourself just to do better with anything. Yeah, that's how it was when I was working out. That's how it was when I was bartending, playing football. It doesn't matter, you know. You should always feel like that you have to be constantly improving yourself. And whenever you fall short of something, that's a good time to use that as an opportunity to get to make sure that, like, you know, okay, well, let's not do it again. How do we fix this? What went wrong? And how do we make sure that it doesn't happen again, or at least it lessens the chance of it happening again? You know. And you might be thinking, like, oh, come on, it's just a silly like streak. You yourself said it was silly. Who cares? Like, you're taking it a little bit too seriously here. It's like, no, I think that you should take stuff like that seriously because it's for work. You know, be dedicated to your craft. I've always firmly believed that doing this job, and I continue to believe that. You know, if you don't treat this like a job, it's not going to treat you like a job, in the sense from a financial standpoint, as well as a response standpoint. So if I set a goal and we fall short, then I've got to be like, all right, well, let's figure out what we did and what can we do to get better. Whether it's better like streak rewards or better commentary. Obviously, I can't really do too much about the runs. Like, not every run's going to have Godhead, Sacred Heart, Brimstone on it. You know, and I wouldn't want that. The super powerful, really special runs being few and far between, those are... That's the perfect degree of separation that I like. You know, every, like, once in a blue moon we have a really, really powerful, like, you know, heart stopping run to where it's like, wow, like we are blowing this game out of the water right now. Wow, that was a fantastic teleport there by the stars card. Could not have asked for a better one if we went straight to the boss. Let's do it. And yes, Mega will still be going. Told you. Now, this is Curse of Darkness, or this is not Curse of Darkness, I mean. It's giving us this effect because we essentially took a Forget Me Now, and the light should come back on. Yeah, there we go. Because the light should come back on pretty soon. I think it was because of us delaying the effect of Mega that caused it to kind of do that. Thank you, Dark Bum, for your service. You too, little Chad. Oh my goodness. And then we get Sack Dagger and Void into Mega. Wow. So this... Now this is a special circumstance here with Void. Because what Void Mega does, Mega turns Void into the premier hard carry item. And that's because you don't have to have the 12... charges to get a full charge. Since it's bound to Void, you only need 6. As you're seeing right here. And that's incredible. That's incredible, I know, Thrall. Jesus juice again. And yeah, we're gonna get bounced around in the fires every now and then. I mean, that's just gonna happen. You gotta expect that. But, oh boy, having Void tied to Mega is just a beautiful thing. And the reason why it's so good is because the reason I just talked about, but also since we've essentially cut down the charge up time in Mega by over half, essentially. The good part about that is that you usually clear, unless you get a really wonky room like we just did with that NASA worm, you usually clear at least 6 rooms or more just secondarily by using Mega. So like you already have a full charge by the time that you've not even gotten done shooting the original Mega shot, and then it's ready to go again with Void. I could have avoided both of that, but I did kind of want a little bit of a tiers upgrade. I also secretly want a movement speed upgrade. Maybe not so secretly anymore. Yeah, we don't care. We don't care about the orbital. We've got Sack Dagger. And even then, we still don't care.
I think you could have gotten a tiers upgrade if you just used the Void instead of taking the apple.
Yeah, but we could have also not gotten a tiers upgrade, though. Dude, see how that works? I'm going to go back into the item room. We can Void Forget Me Now. It's only going to activate once, but we'll get another crack at this floor. Yeah, this can't be a library because libraries are not double locked. Then we get the Invicta Robes, which I will take. The left hand is our trinket, by the way, and the left hand is going to give us all red chests. So any chests that drop are guaranteed to be red, which are great, especially if you're looking for Guppy. Not so great if you're looking for anything else. Also very good if you are looking just for soul hearts and whatnot. Of course, we always are. We've already been to the Devil Deal, so there's no reason for me to go in there. I'm just going to get a full charge on Mega. By Mega, I mean Void, and then we're going to back out. And we're going to Void Forget Me Now, and then we're just going to do it again. How cool is that? We also get a stat up from Harlequin Baby, so that's even cooler. And speaking of Harlequin, be careful now. Speaking of Harlequin, I've been having, I have finished, I think, seasons 1. I don't know if, like, Netflix says that it was season 2 for 7 Deadly Sins, but I'm like, it was a 4 episode, like, filler arc. If that's what they're calling season 2, then that's like one of the worst season 2s that in not just anime history, but television history. And I'm on episode like 8 or 9 of season 3 now, so it's been pretty good. Some people had told me that I would not like season 3. Like they said that it's actually gotten much worse, and I disagree. I think that 7 Deadly Sins has been fairly consistent for most of the entire anime. One thing I definitely can appreciate, and it's funny because one, I don't remember who it was. I think it may have been Slater. One of the characters says, like, I can't believe how fast this is going on. I can't believe how fast this is moving when they're talking about, like, a major story plot thing. And I actually sort of, like, appreciated that because, like, the anime doesn't mess around. I'm going to take Mom's knife only because I'm tired of shooting myself with a pickaxe. And by that, I mean running into spikes for no reason at all. But the anime moves at a very impressive pace throughout all the seasons. I've been very, very entertained by it. And it's a nice, refreshing. There's no way to do this safely, unless there's a soul heart in here. Nope. It's a refreshing way of doing anime, or not just anime, but like stories in general, not having all the BSing around, and, you know, oh well, we gotta stop by this town first to make sure this happens. Like, no, seven deadly sins just does that. It's one and done. You know what, something like in like Naruto, which would have taken it would have taken forever to do some of the stuff in Seven Deadly Sins. Like, they, like, what they do is they do stuff that Naruto would have taken like 4 or 5 episodes to do, and even then it still like would still take a while, you know. So I appreciate that. I'm glad that I started watching it because of the game. A lot of people still loving playing the game too. Seven Deadly Sins Grand Cross. I'm not exactly sure what the official title is. It's like Seven Deadly Sins Hikari no Grand Cross, something like that. We have a very active guild on there. I'm hoping that they raise the requirements, or they raise the member limit as well, because it's at 30. It's been stuck at 30, and we've been full for a while there. We're gonna avoid Polydactyl here. I thought about going and getting Satanic Bible. I probably should have, but it is what it is. And do I hate that saying? You know when somebody can't back up an argument that they presented to themselves by whenever they say it is what it is. I mean, when I hear somebody say that, I'm like, okay, so you just can't think of a good like supporting claim to whatever you're trying to bring up, so you're just gonna say that, huh? I mean, I'm guilty of it too. You know, sometimes you can't straw man everything without you shouldn't be straw manning anyway, really, but. There are going to be times where it's like, yeah, I can't think of anything else to say about this. I'll say my piece and just say, it is what it is. Yeah, you know, it is what it is. Datamire. Crack the skizzle. Be honest, I don't really want any of these items. I definitely do not want to void this room. I'll begrudgingly take Speedball. So, because I used that chariot card, it wasn't allowing me to move the Mega Beam, Mega Blast. I just wanted to do Boss Rush from Mega because it's just so fun. Super easy. An Ipecac infused Mega Blast is pretty terrifying. Now, if we could just get flying here. Flying would be most excellent. And you're seeing the beauty that is Team Mega Blast here. And we get fast bombs. Hooray. Terrific. Yeah, I'm still going to say it's over here. And to remind myself for a second there that we do not have... Holy Mantle anymore. Or Dark Bomb. Matriarch for the second time. Great boss, blah, 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 blah. Still really enjoying Bannerlord. I put probably another 20 hours into that game now since the last couple of days have transpired. It's like, it's a perfect, like, chill out game. It's not chill out in the way that Animal Crossing is chill out, but, like, there's just something about the medieval simulation aspect of it that I think honestly a lot of it comes from the sound design of the game as well. But I have my own faction now. Like, I've made my own kingdom. I did the main quest line, and you gotta find a dragon banner or some stuff like that. I don't know. It's something to that effect. And after you do that, you actually get the ability to see old Usher. But you also get the ability to create your own kingdom, like your own faction. And, you know, so I've been enjoying doing that and kind of romping around and just doing my thing, trying to build up my cred, my street cred for all the kids, you know, all the kids and all the empires who think I'm cool. No one thinks I'm cool. What are you? Power card. Yeah. Was there? I probably should have waited. There's a full charge in there. Well, we have Nun's Habit. Most likely we're going to take a hit here. Oh, this is not doing nearly as much damage as you would think. I mean, we've got Ipecac game. I'm pretty sure that our Ipecac infused knife is doing more damage to Hush than Mega did. Which is very odd. Gonna purposely take a hit here because we've got all these adds and I wanna get in and use some Sack Dagger goodness. So what the knife did there was thanks to me using the magician card, Spoonbender. Spoonbender kind of took over there for a second. Pay no attention to the floppy knife. It's not gonna hurt you. It's gonna hurt Hush. It's not gonna hurt us. Down goes old Hush. Yeah, we'll go ahead and use that. Go ahead and Bobby bombs him. Can I get into the light? Can I get into the light? I can. So, awesome that we get to kick off the week with a fun run after the little bit of the downer that is losing the like streak. And let me know in the comments. Let me know what other stuff that you'd like to possibly consider for the like streak goal. You know, I like to remind everybody that you all are ultimately who is in charge on this channel. You know, you guys and gals get to make the big decisions on the channel. And it doesn't always necessarily mean I'm going to agree with them, but it's all, you know, listening. I think listening to your audience is an important part of YouTube. And if you don't do that, you're not only doing yourself a great disservice, but also like you're potentially losing out on success, I think. That's just my own personal theory on that. And blast through Isaac here. Or this is not the right way to go. Okay. That is actually kind of shocking, considering that this is that's how normally the cathedral plays out. Not that it made a difference, of course, but a little bit of a shocker there. Curse the Maze. We'll use the Sun card and go for the Diggity Dunk, Magic Mush, and Serpent's Kiss. Oh my goodness. Well, I was going to leave Magic Mush there, but not this time around. We had a run on stream this past week where I actually did not take Magic Mush, and people were losing their freaking minds. If you gotta question why, I don't think you really understand how important Polar Invincibility is. That was a nine lives run that had we needed HP, I would have much preferred to have Magic Mush sitting before me right there just waiting, but it worked out. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Let me know in the comments down below what you would like to see for a new like streak goal. We have Angel Deal Week coming up. If we can continue a brand new like streak going on into 30, and if not, then we'll reevaluate and drop the like streak counter and see what else we can come up with. So thank you all very much. Again, one final time, hope you all had a great Easter holiday for those of you who celebrated it. Thank you very much for the support. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.